Good morning, everyone. Welcome. Delighted to see all of you. I think it's a great turnout. I think our Science Board co-chairs have put together a terrific program today. Very much looking forward to. I think it's no surprise to anyone that the last few years have been difficult ones for nonprofits throughout the country. SFI, no exception, but I'm pleased to say that things are coming back. We're in really relatively great shape. Jennifer Dunn, our chair of faculty, will be reporting both to the Science Board tomorrow and the Board of Trustees on Sunday. A number of advances in terms of faculty, postdocs, grants, and programs, visitors. There's not a desk to be had this summer anywhere in the Institute. And so we feel that we have great momentum going into this, our 30th anniversary year. A lot of exciting things. We'll have a host of events throughout the year, and we obviously hope to keep the momentum going at least for another 30 years or more. So we're delighted that all of you are here. We'll be hearing a whole really terrific group of speakers, as well as four of our newest Omidyar postdoctoral fellows later this morning. So without further ado, I want to introduce our two Science Board co-chairs. First, Dan Stein, NYU, sends his deepest regrets. He has a little video weighing things today or tomorrow morning. His daughter's being married. SFI Science Board. He said it was a hard choice, but he finally came down on his daughter's wedding, but obviously regrets not being here. We have a brief video, and then Mimi Koehl of Berkeley will come and give us background for today's talk. So again, welcome indeed, and let's have a video from Dan.
I'd like to welcome you all to the symposium and the Science Board meeting, and thank you all for coming. I apologize for not being at this meeting. As you may know, my presence is required elsewhere this weekend. And while I'm sorry to miss Saturday's Science Board meeting, I really regret missing Friday's symposium. I think we put together a superb set of topics and speakers, and Mimi will discuss this in greater detail. For my part, I just want to thank the speakers for agreeing to participate, and the administration and staff at SFI for all of their work and advice in putting this program together. Turning to Saturday's meeting, we have a new feature. Following the discussion at last year's meeting, three ad hoc committees have been put together to advise the Science Board on SFI's postdoc program, their workshops program, and their educational and outreach activities. The function of these committees is to study the issues, report their findings to the Science Board so that the Science Board is better equipped to play a more active role at SFI within its mission of providing the best possible advice to the president and administration of SFI. Now, this is an experiment. We'll see how well it works, and based on that, we'll determine how best to move forward, or not, with this new initiative. With all that being said, let me welcome you again. Thank you all for coming, and I very much hope that you all enjoy the next 2 days.
So I'm Mimi Koehl. I'm the other co-chair of the Science Board this year, and I again want to thank the staff for setting this up and welcome all of you and thank you for your service either as trustees or Science Board members. And traditionally, this Friday day of talks is meant to be the treat to us on the Science Board and the trustees for coming here to do our work. So we get our little intellectual candy today and then we settle down to work over the weekend. But this year we have two other purposes for today's talks in addition. One, which Jerry mentioned, is to introduce you to some of SFI's Omidyar postdocs and let you hear some of the kinds of research that they're doing. And the other is to highlight some areas of intellectual activity that SFI is currently engaged in. And those of us who've been on the Science Board many years know that we come here and every year we have these discussions about what direction should SFI take going forward? Should SFI just be the pioneers developing new approaches and techniques to deal with complex problems? Or should SFI use these kinds of approaches to address important real-world problems and interface with empirical data? And we go back and forth and back and forth. So today, our topic is complexity, theory, and practice. And we've selected speakers that fall at different places along that spectrum so that we can see showcased for us all these different approaches that SFI and people affiliated with SFI are currently engaged in. And all of our speakers have some sort of association with SFI. Our speakers come from a diversity of fields in which they were initially trained, although all of them now are doing transdisciplinary research. And they're all very distinguished. And if when I introduced each speaker, I read to you all their honors and awards, then there wouldn't be time for their talk. But there are bios of them that you can look at. So what I want to do when I introduce each speaker is simply tell you the background they came from and then evolved to this more transdisciplinary place, tell you their association with SFI, and tell you what they're going to talk about today. So each talk will be 40 minutes, and then we'll have 10 minutes for discussion. And Ginny, where's Ginny? She will be the enforcer, and she's got cards she's going to hold up that the essential message is wrap up soon and then shut up, although I think she'll just have times written on them. But that's the message, and so she'll keep us on track. So the three areas that we're going to look at today are networks, ecology, and scaling. And we'll start this morning with networks. And our